exceptional story in Army Specialist Christopher Hoyt. Hoyt was seriously wounded on foot patrol in Iraq back on the 13th of November. Two of Hoyt's fellow soldiers were killed in that attack. But only hours after the ambush, Hoyt told his commanding officers his job in Iraq is not finished. We welcome to America's Newsroom Army Specialist Christopher Hoyt. Sir, good morning to you.
Hey, good morning. How are you guys doing?
How about you? Sound great.
Oh, well, I'm trying to keep up a good attitude as best I can.
Yeah, I am so impressed when I hear voices like yours, and I meet other wounded vets from Iraq or Afghanistan, and their lives are so dramatically different now than before their injuries, and they're going out and changing people's lives today through motivational speaking or however they're contributing back. I think it's awesome. Really great. Let me ask you a question about what happened to you. Your injuries, how bad were you hurt?
Well, I got banged up pretty good. I've got a broken heel bone. My ankle bones are kind of broken up pretty good. There's a hole on the back side of my knee that kind of, when shrapnel went in there, it's about the size of a silver dollar, and it kind of knocked out a piece of my tibia. And then I got a pretty good soul-sized hole in my thigh, and then I got one in my butt.
Wow, you were pretty banged up. There are two other soldiers nearby who were killed in the same thing.
Yes.
This same incident, this IED. You had about 12 hours of surgery. The doctor save your life, specialist?
You know, I can't say yes or no, probably. Okay. But what I attribute to probably saving my life the most is the care that I got in the first hour on the ground. The soldier medics and the medical personnel at Balad Air Base and the hospital there is really, you know, if my life had to be saved, and I'm sure it would have because I had a lot of blood loss going on.
Well, they call that the golden hour, and it's so critical. And the U.S. military has gotten so good at it, too.
Right.
Before you left the emergency room, you said you wanted to re-enlist.
Right.
What is not finished in your mind, specialist?
Well, I had always intended on re-enlisting. That was just already a foregone conclusion for me. So, you know, just going out there and getting back after it and getting back into the fight, or at least, you know, being able to train soldiers and contribute something so that, you know, more soldiers can come home is really the ultimate goal.
Yeah, is the Army going to let you do this?
You know, as far as I know, this, you know, I haven't really, but there's an entire medical process of evaluation that they're probably going to have to go through, but I don't see why not. I know myself, and I can rehab myself back into at least returning to duty.
I think your attitude alone might bring you back to full strength. Are you walking yet? What are you doing?
Oh, no, I'm not walking yet. I've rolled around on a wheelchair a couple of times, but I'm pretty much in bed right now the whole time.
Heal well, okay?
Oh, thanks.
Age 26, but specialist Christopher Hoyt.
Wow.
He's got two brothers. Wants to rejoin the fight.
How lucky.